The major markets continued the gains in the domestic market, while the emerging markets experienced a pullback. The S&P 500 traded lower on Monday as the markets geared up for Fed Chairman Jerome Powell's semi-annual testimony before Congress. While Powell didn't directly state that the Fed would be lowering interest rates, his prepared remarks stated that inflation has been running below the Federal Open Market Committee's symmetric 2% objective, and cross-currents, such as trade tensions and concerns about global growth, have been weighing on economic activity and the outlook. Later in his testimony, he stated that the economy is in a very good place, and that we want to use our tools to keep it there. It's very important that this expansion continues as long as possible. Markets took this testimony as further confirmation of a rate decrease. According to the CME Group FedWatch tool, probabilities of a rate decrease have remained above 50% since May 31st. Furthermore, the possibility of a rate reduction of 50 basis points increased even further as the week progressed. The Fed has struggled to justify the action of a rate decrease while the unemployment rate is near a 50-year low. Additionally, Thursday's release of the Consumer Price Index highlighted a reading of 2.1% on a year-over-year basis. Nonetheless, markets have continued to move higher, anticipating a policy change at the next meeting. By the end of last week, the S&P 500 closed above 3,000 for the first time, ending the week within a point of the all-time intraday high.